right here, sir. How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm great. Now, you're out here today. Obviously, you have a huge sign, and you want your voice to be heard today.
Okay.
Can you explain why you're out here today, and what is your message?
I'm here to basically put out the true message of Christ. Now,
right.
I know a lot of people will say that, a lot of different denominations, but if you read the scriptures, you'll find out for yourself.
Sure.
I would say the first thing is that the Vatican and the Catholic Church is a political organization, and I'm against the church becoming a political organization.
Right. Now, it kind of seems like his message is more of a political one. We haven't even heard him say Jesus once since he's been in Washington.
Is that true?
I don't understand what's going on. He had the meeting in New York about the 9/11 meeting, you know, and
yeah.
And people were saying all over the internet, they're like, this man has his own agenda, it's climate change, it's this. It just seems more political than spiritual.
Yeah.
So, I mean, is he a false prophet? What do you say?
I would say, yes, he is a false prophet. Let me start with this.
Sure.
Since you asked about the Pope, we'll begin right at Babylon.
Okay.
If we go to, hold on, let me get this on first.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
No, take your time now, take your time. I mean, this is where people need to hear, obviously, the truth.
Right here you have Adam and Eve, right?
Yep.
And Eve had Cain, Abel, and Seth. Cain and Abel were the first two.
Right.
Cain killed Abel.
Uh-huh.
And down his line,
Nimrod.
His great-great-grandson, I'm sorry, was
uh-huh.
Nimrod.
Right.
And then you see down on Seth's line, Jesus came from Seth's line. Now, in the New Testament, we see, for this is the message that he heard from the beginning,
right.
That we should love one another.
Yes.
Not as Cain, who was of that wicked one. So Cain was basically the first Satanist.
Right.
He was of that wicked one.
Mm-hmm.
And down in his line, we had Nimrod, who built Babylon and Nineveh and many other cities, but the two most notorious are Babylon and Nineveh.
Right.
Jonah preached in Nineveh, which was a pagan nation that converted when Jonah preached them.
Right.
Now, he was around during the Tower of Babel, Nimrod.
Sure.
He was under the rulership of Babel. So now, we come up to the Pope. Here's a picture of Nimrod, right here.
Right there, yeah.
Now, he's Babylonian. You come down here.
Yeah, it's the Dagon.
And he's worshipped as Dagon, yes.
Yeah.
And Dagon, in the Old Testament, he was the Philistine god.
And look at the Pope's hat. Look at the hat he's wearing.
Yeah, he's got the fish mitre.
Yeah.
So basically,
right.
I believe that he came right from the Babylonian line, you know.
Right.
And is basically an infiltration into Christianity.
Right.
I believe that Catholicism came about when they tried to suppress Christianity, but they couldn't. So what did they do? They put on a Christian guise, and then they started deceiving others.
Sure.
And said, we're the church. But they weren't.
Now, I mean, a lot of people say about the Pope, they're saying how he supports a one world religion, he supports a one world government, and, you know, he just really wants to, which is, in my opinion, it's not cool, because, you know, he should be supporting
basically a world power, right?
Right.
Yeah, that's what now let's go back to Babel. That's what Babel was.
Okay.
Babel was basically the first New World Order, pretty much.
So it was the first New World Order, right?
What happened is the world was of one language,
yes.
one people,
uh-huh.
so on and so forth, and they wanted to build a tower into heaven to take God's place, pretty much.
And you think that, I mean, well, what are you about thinking? It's kind of unfolding in front of us. Thank you so much, my friend, for being out here. If you have any links you want to share, any websites you want to share, let everybody know.
I only have one last thing to say.
Sure.
There should not be a hierarchy in the church. Jesus Christ, he is the high priest, and the believers are all priests. So anyone that believes in Jesus Christ is a priest.
And that means we don't, you know, stop worshiping Pope Francis. You have to go through Jesus to get to heaven.
Yep.
It's no other way around it. That's how it is. Thank you so much, my friend, and love and light to you.
All right, thank you.